What has been surprising for me through this whole journey is, well, there's a few things that have been surprising. One is how significant an impact the life of someone you've never met could have on you. For me, that first experience was with Layla Peterson, a 5-year-old little girl who I never met, and yet being called to the family after her tragic death changed my life. In fact, it changed my whole life course. I never would have imagined that I would be coordinating a program like this. I had been a happy congregational pastor, and now I am only part-time as a pastor and then part-time running this program as coordinator with the Salvation Army. Someone I never met changed my life. And so that's what I've seen at these scenes, is that when we let ourselves become open to meeting people in their worst moments, when we are able to share in solidarity in that suffering and to sit with people in those moments, that does amazing things for me personally. And I've heard similar things from my chaplains. I think that I have become a better pastor because of this work that I've done. I think that I'm a better person. I am able to see suffering and see pain, but I'm also able to see how communities can come together and how the faith community can work with people. And to be able to be a part of the networking that is happening because of this is just an honor. The other thing that I didn't learn through this chaplaincy program, but it has affirmed it for me, both as a pastor, but then now especially as a chaplain, we have the privilege of being able to be with people in their most intimate moments, these intimate and painful moments. And to be able to be let into that is a privilege, an honor, and it is a responsibility. And for me, as a pastor and as a person of faith, it's also holy. It's a holy thing to be allowed into these families, for even for just a short period of time. So this experience as a chaplain has been really a faith formative thing for me. And I'm grateful that I've been able to have this experience. And I'm grateful that 51 other people get to have this experience with my chaplains. It has similarly been formative for them, if you hear their stories about what it has meant to be with these families and to walk with them in these times of crisis. Though I didn't know it at the time, I think a number of my life experiences have prepared me for this. Now, at the time, did I know that it was going to prepare me to be a coordinator of chaplains at homicide scenes? Absolutely not. But my experience in the parish and in various Lutheran congregations certainly has prepared me in terms of how to work with families who are experiencing painful moments, and in how to work with various people of faith to share in resources. I certainly had some skills developed in my pastoral ministry in that way. I had done a year of missionary work in Edinburgh, Scotland after I graduated from college, and that experience allowed me to work with vulnerable and at-risk persons. Again, having this sensibility of how do you care for people who are experiencing traumatic incidents. Now, in Scotland, I was working with homeless persons and people who were experiencing addiction. So it was a very different kind of trauma. It was sort of a continual trauma rather than a, you know, this sharp, specific, you know, one-off incident. But to learn how to work in those situations, I think that helped prepare me. In my clinical pastoral education, I spent a summer as a chaplain working in Chicago with something called the Night Ministry, and we worked with homeless LGBT teens. And that work actually had me working with the police very often, And so that helped me understand some of the roles and some of the ways that police get called into various scenes. So all these little things have helped me have a background that I think I'm able to rely on. But many times it does just feel that this is just the place that my journey has taken me. And I think because I was becoming very active as a congregational pastor and getting to know my community better, that is what naturally led me to the place where I knew the captain very well, which led him to call me to the scene at Layla. And because I'd been at that scene, I was interested in the chaplaincy program and as active in the chaplaincy program when it first started, then I got asked to coordinate the program. And I think it seemed natural of a flow. Again, very surprising. I never would have imagined that this is where I went, but I believe I have the skills and the gifts that were needed at the right time. I have a gift for organization and for detail. I'm detail oriented. I have a deep understanding for how good administration helps further ministry. And so this new program needed a strong administrator, needed someone who could organize all the chaplains and manage all their training and manage all the calls for service and connect with resources and to do all of that in 20 hours a week, part-time. And I had those skills, and I believe God called me at the right time in my life, but also in the life of the program to help really get it going in the way that it needed to.